I share my passion with the people closest to me, mainly by getting out there and charging the most. You know, I try to be inspiring in my actions rather than anything else I do.
Intuition got me in the mission. We see eye to eye, but you ain't in my vision. Oh no, I said oh no. Back in the day, I used to say a girl like you, I used to pray for days for. Now my ear like way more. What the fuck would I stay for? Why the fuck would I pay for? Something is just gonna kill me. Nikki, you steal me, but I'm just better. It's been 6 months since we touched last, but I grow fast with this letter, and I swear to God that I'm better.
He would go and whoever was on the trip with him, he would always take his mom with him, you know. And that was amazing. Like, it was really, really good. Like, he would go to a bar and have beers with friends, and his mom would be there with him, you know. And we would go to a nightclub and dance, and his mom would go with us and be there and dance, you know. Like, that was really, really inspiring to me. And I remember to be one day on this nightclub, and it's late, like it's 1 a.m., it's 2 a.m., and I remember to look at him dancing with his mom, and I was thinking, man, I wish my mom was here too, you know?
Drop everything now, meet me in the pouring rain. Kiss me on the sidewalk, take away the pain, cause I see sparks of love in every
when he was in Hawaii before the trip, getting ready for the trip, and he was packing his stuff. I think for a few minutes, maybe he just went to the toilet, or his friend just sneaked in the room and took everything off the bag and just put Hawaiian shirts on it. And if it was somebody else, like if it was me, and I get to Copenhagen and now I see 14 Hawaiian shirts, I think I would have gone to a market and buy some shirts, buy some t-shirts, you know. But he just enjoyed it. Like, he enjoyed the challenge. And
well, he wore Hawaiian shirts for 2 months straight.
Yeah,
all in Arizona, just longboarding around everywhere with Hawaiian shirts. He would go to the gym and work out, Hawaiian shirt on, and everywhere he went, he had a Hawaiian shirt. And then he ended up going over to Europe like that.
And it was a long trip, and he only had those 14 shirts. So, and he was just,
and board shorts.
I remember to see him sometimes just taking the shirt from the bag and yeah, still good. You know, like this shirt is still okay. You know,
that's good. Board shorts, same thing. He's like, ah, they're good for one more day.
They are good. One more day. Yeah.
Same situation. He's one of those jumpers that, like, if it was any one of us, our gear doesn't show up, we're kind of like, all right, we're going to wait for our gear to show up. Gage, board shorts. I think he had a tank top on and borrowed my rig, had somebody else's shoes, a helmet, just jumping. But he hit hard, and he hit the water, and he, like, the way he hit, and it made him go forward, and he went, like, face first into the ground, and the first thing he got up and asked was his teeth okay. First thing he got up today, he's like, are our teeth okay? And he's bleeding, and he's got blood coming out of it. And you know, I'm just
they're
like,
still shining, boy.
Y'all, they're still shining. A little bit of mud in there, but they were shining. Yeah, but and you know what? He got up. The ambulance came, and they saw him. And I think within like 15 minutes, he was fine, back at it, and jumping again. Like, he was just that type of competitor that was relentless. And but that's just who he was, and he got up doing it with a smile on his face. So.
He obviously went out in style with that haircut of his, and he was like, I'm bringing the mullet back, I'm doing it, you know what I mean? And he showed me this video of this high school wrestler. He might have showed you guys. This high school wrestler had this amazing mullet, and he was doing a sports interview after he won some championship.
Big Ten champion, this story program in this arena, pretty special day for you.
Yeah, I mean, it did get loud in here. I think these fans just respond really well to a good haircut. So that's what I was working on coming in here, to making sure I had it fluffed and feathered the right way. And I think the fans saw my hard work.
And he said, this guy's my hero. Because the interview is amazing. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna start practicing. Every time there's a mic put in my face, I'm only gonna talk about my hair. And because he just like wanted to for some weird reason, and then he got his opportunity in at the Swoop Challenge in Copenhagen, because it was literally like he's rocking this amazing mullet. He had these speed stripes on the side. He'd make a great run, and then as soon as you come out of the water, you go to this like interview section, and you know there's somebody right there to ask you questions about how the run was and blah blah blah, and like tell me about that freestyle move and all that kind of stuff. And all Gage did was talk about his hair. He would never answer the question.
Gage, come on over here. Look at that hair. Look at that hair. It is absolutely beautiful. Come follow me, Gage. Gage, first jump of the competition, second year. How are you feeling about your first jump?
It felt really nice. I feel like I had the mullet really flowing in the wind on that one. Hopefully I can get my speed lines to be a little more effective on the next one, so I can stick the wrap a little better, but feeling good.
I can see tomorrow all the kids turning up with mullets and speed lines. How does it feel to be back in Copenhagen, and are you going for the title this year?
Absolutely spectacular, actually. Stoked to be jumping finally. As soon as I got the invitation, started growing out the mullet, so feeling good, good form.
Beautiful, thank you very much. Business up front, party in the back, back to you in the studio.
Classic Gage, for some reason it just was like everything, like, about him and his sense of humor, his carefree attitude, and his love of life just kind of was hilarious to watch. He definitely made people smile.
There's something happening here, but what it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a gun over there, telling me I got to beware. I think it's time we stop, children, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. There's battle lines being drawn. Nobody's right if everybody's wrong. Young people speak in their minds are getting so much resistance from behind. Time we stop, hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going down. What a field day for the heat. A thousand people in the street singing songs and a carry inside.
Like every second he could get, you'd see him doing push-ups or doing some sit-ups or whatever, you know, and you know, eventually you ask him, you know, dude, you're hardcore about this physical fitness. And he's like, for the hits and for the chicks, baby.
Yeah.
You know, like, because he knew
he's gonna get hit.
He was gonna pound in a lot.
Yeah.
Because of his nature. Yeah. And for the chicks, obviously.
Yeah, always for the chicks.
It was a good line.
For the hits and the chicks, boy.
What was this other line he had when we would be at a restaurant and we have a few minutes to look at the menu and choose the food, like, what do we want?
Yeah, yeah.
And he would never open the menu,
order.
Right? Yeah, he would just wait and you would
like
be ordering.
In the moment.
And then, yeah, we are ready to make the order. And the bartender would come.
Yeah, yeah. And he'd say,
come to me last.
Come to me last, you know, or something like that. And then he'd, as soon as they'd get to the waitress would get to him, he'd open it up and like quickly try and decide. And I asked him, why do you do that, man? And he's like, I do it for the rush. It's like, you're trying to order
food. Gotta
he's
make
trying
exciting.
To make, trying to make his menu ordering experience a rush.
Yeah, that was Gage.
Yeah.